At this time, please turn off or silence all electronic devices. Today we celebrate Pentecost Sunday. The readings can be found in our hymnals number 1028. Father Kuno will be the celebrant for the 10 a.m. Mass next Sunday. A reception will be light refreshments in front of the Walson Center following the Mass. The second collection next Sunday is for Father's Day intentions, which will be remembered at the Masses throughout the remainder of the month. We remember in our prayers the intention of this Mass, members of the Memorial Fund and the Siena Society. Pentecost marks the conclusion and the goal of the Easter season. It is a memorial of the day the Holy Spirit descended upon the apostles and the Virgin Mary in the form of fiery tongues. The Paschal mystery, the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of Jesus culminates in the sending of the Holy Spirit. On this birthday of the Church, let us be strengthened in our call to be witnesses of our faith in Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Christ,
Let us pray. O God, who by the mystery of today's great feast sanctify your whole church in every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth. And with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of believers through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, there were all in one place together, and suddenly there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each one of them, and they were filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak in different tongues as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were astounded, and in amazement, they asked, "Are not all these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear them in his native language? We are Parthians, Medes, Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Egypt, and the districts of Libya near Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans, and Arabs, yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues of the mighty acts of God, the word of the Lord."
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, No one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God, who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. As a body is one, though it has many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also Christ. For in one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of one Spirit, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Come, Holy Spirit, come, and from your celestial home shed a ray of light divine. Come, Father of the poor, come, source of all our store. Come, within our bosoms shine, you of comforters the best. You, the soul's most welcome guest, sweet refreshment here below, in our labor rest most sweet, grateful coolness in the heart, solace in the midst of woe. O most blessed light divine, shine within these hearts of yours, your own inmost being fill. Where you are not, we have not, nothing good in deed or thought, nothing free from taint of ill. Heal our wounds, our strength renewed. On our dryest pour your dew, wash the stains of guilt away, bend the stubborn heart and will, melt the frozen, warm the chill. Guide the steps that go astray on the faithful who adore, and confess you evermore in your sevenfold gift descend. Give them virtue's sure reward. Give them your salvation, Lord. Give them joys that never end. Amen. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Praise you.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always. Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our dwelling with him. Those who do not love me do not keep my words. Yet the word you hear is not mine, but that of the Father who sent me. I have told you this while I am with you. The Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I told you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. So not to start on a downer, though perhaps for some of you it's cause for joy, but this is my last weekend here at the cathedral. I fly out on Friday for that rescheduled trip to the Passion Play in Oberammergau from 2020. I land on Monday the 20th, and I move on Tuesday the 21st. Father Sinowitz has been gracious enough to allow me to preach all the Masses, not just my own, except for the 11:30, because apparently the bishop takes precedence. Okay. And so obviously it's a bit sad for me to be up here today and celebrating my last regular Sunday Mass here at the Cathedral of St. Catherine of Siena. But if I had to pick a day to go out, Pentecost is a great one. If you would have been here last night, the vigil has different readings, and one of them is the Tower of Babel. That kind of final moment in what scripture scholars call the prehistory, that kind of bird's eye view of the human race from creation fall up through Abraham, where then we begin to look more particularly at the covenants God gives to eventually bring salvation to the whole human race. And Babel kind of is this capstone of what happened in the fall. In the fall, the great lie of the devil is that if you do this thing against God's will, if you reach out and take this, you will be like gods. But God has made us in his image and likeness. We were made to be like God. So the great lie is we should try to grasp under our own power what we can only receive as a gift. And throughout the fall, the cause of the fall is disunity. Disunity in ourselves, both in the sense that without the loss of the grace of original justice, our material bodies can once again decay and death enters the human race, as well as that injury to mind and will that leads to us, as St. Paul says, not doing the good we want to do, but instead doing the evil we don't want to do. That powerful struggle in us between our passions and our choices for the higher things. And as that plays out, it brings disunity in humanity. Adam and Eve, who were created to walk side by side as partners, now with the possibility of recognizing each other in nakedness, the possibility for lust, for corruption, for desire to dominate, enters into the human race. Between husband and wife, between brother and brother, as we see with Cain and Abel, and then through that, through the human race in its entirety. As the great men, the giants, are raised up, but they're great because of their violence, and eventually God sends the flood. And yet here, after that, at Babel, once again man reaches to grab what can only be given. Desiring to be like God, they say, we will build a tower to the heavens. A desire to enter into, to climb and ascend to the throne of God under their own power. And so God confuses their language so they cannot communicate. And that ultimate division of man into nations and tribes and peoples who cannot speak to each other plays out. Sin brings division. So Pentecost is the undoing of all that. As our Lord on the cross, through his passion and death, resurrection, and ascension, undoes the sin of our first parents, makes up for it, so in sending his Spirit now, he undoes the fullness of what that sin brings, the disunity. And so on their first sermon, on this birthday of the church, where the apostles go out for the first time and proclaim Christ crucified and risen, everybody, Jews and converts to Judaism from all over the known world, they hear that gospel message in their own language. Pentecost undoes Babel. The final undoing of the sin of our first parents and its results. And so now the church speaks with every language of mankind. Everywhere in the world, praise is given to God from every tribe and tongue and people and nation. And that unity is the point. That unity is the important thing. As St. Paul says, we are one body in Christ. By that one Spirit, by that which the church will call the soul of the church, by that one Spirit, just as the soul makes the body one, so the Spirit makes all members of the church, everywhere they are, one. One in that font, where we call down the power of the Holy Spirit over that water. as he came down over the waters of creation when God brought order and unity out of chaos, creating the world from nothing. As he came down over the Red Sea so that Israel might go from slavery to freedom, and again over the Jordan so that they might pass from wandering into the land of promise. So too that Spirit comes so that we might be a new creation. We might go from slavery to sin to the freedom of the children of God, that we might enter into the promised land, the true promised land, the kingdom of our Heavenly Father. It's by the power of that Spirit that men are ordained priests, as Father Kuna was ordained literally 24 hours ago, right here in this sanctuary. And by the power of that Spirit and that ordination, he is called down on that altar so that bread and wine become the body and blood, soul and divinity of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, so that receiving him as our food for the journey, we might become what we receive, the body of Christ, the church in the world. The church is one in faith, one in baptism, one in the one chalice and the one loaf. The church is one. And that unity is more than any separation that the world can bring, which is why in another place, St. Paul will say, what can separate us from the love of Christ? Not death, not fire, not the sword. Because the church isn't even just us. It's not just our parish. It's not just our diocese, the Church of Allentown. It's not even just the church in this world. By the Holy Spirit, by being one in Christ, by that Spirit, we are united with all the saints and angels of the church triumphant who have achieved final entrance into that land of promise. By that Spirit, we are one with the church suffering, the souls in purgatory undergoing their final cleansing so that they too might enter into the full vision of God. By the Spirit, not time, not distance, not even death separates the members of the church from each other. And so this isn't goodbye, because we're not separated. We are one in faith, one in the Eucharist, one in the Holy Spirit, one church. So no matter where we go, we are united. And so yes, when priests are transferred, when children go off to college or begin their own lives, when we move to a new place because we have to, or start a new job, there is pain for human affection, for the love we had for people that we are leaving, or people that are leaving us. But at its deepest, none of these things separate us, because we are one in Christ, one in the Spirit that he sent, one in the Spirit that has been poured into our hearts, one in the Spirit that transforms the gifts on this altar into that holy communion that unites us with God and with each other. That is Pentecost. That is the promise of the Holy Spirit. That is the promise of the sacraments, the promise of our faith. No matter where we are one. United in faith with all the saints, from our first parents to those saints who just passed away, possibly just at this minute, whose names are known but to God. So as we come to this altar today, let us ask our Lord, who makes us one by the power of the Holy Spirit in the breaking of the bread, that we who receive the one Christ in the Eucharist by the power of that one Spirit that makes the church a living body united all over the world, throughout time and into eternity, let us ask him that by our reception worthily of his body, blood, soul, and divinity, we may continue to be one, that we might live united in faith, united in our baptismal bonds, united around this altar. If we seek to live that faith, then nothing will separate us from the love of Christ, and therefore nothing will separate us from each other. Because as one church, the body of Christ in the world, the body of Christ triumphant, suffering, and militant here on earth in the middle of the struggle, we will be one, united forever until that moment when he comes again in glory. And we, as St. John tells us, will be like him because we will see him as he is. That is the promise of the Spirit, the undoing of sin, the undoing of division, a unity that can never be broken because it has its origin in God, a unity that will unite us in life and in death and unto eternity. And may God bless us all today. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in the guidance of the Holy Spirit, we bring forth the needs of our brothers and sisters.
That the Holy Spirit increase the gifts given to church leaders to boldly proclaim the good news of the risen Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That each day, Father Matthew Kuna, and all priests be more closely comforted to Christ and his most secret heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit move government officials and leaders to serve their constituents justly and peacefully, especially in Ukraine. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families separated by military services, that they find ways to stay close in relationship despite the physical distances. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died this week, including Clarence Hansenman Jr., and especially for the members enrolled in the Memorial Fund in the Siena Society, whom we remember in this Mass. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray that the gifts you have given help us grow in relationship with you. Hear the prayers we offer through the Holy Spirit and through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of this sacrifice and graciously lead us into all truth, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For bringing your paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children, by uniting them to your only begotten Son. This same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God, and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis our Pope and Alfred our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of Pentecost, on which the Holy Spirit appeared to the apostles in tongues of fire and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as one you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants, who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
And teach we dare to say, Our Father, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace, your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain all its force, and that this spiritual food may gain her abundance of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just one announcement. As I said in my homily, Deacon Kuna was ordained Father Kuna just about 24 hours ago right here in this sanctuary. Just so you know, next week, next weekend at the 10 o'clock Mass, he will be celebrating that Mass, and then there'll be some light refreshments and a chance to congratulate him and hopefully receive his first blessing over outside between the Walston Center and the school in that little breezeway. If we have a nice day, it'll be a nice breeze in there, and if we have a bad day, there's a roof over our heads. So either way. And also, just so you all know, he did receive his assignment yesterday. He will be assigned to St. Catherine's. Unfortunately, it's the other St. Catherine's in Reading, and he will also be the chaplain to Berks Catholic High School. So please keep him in your prayers as he spends the next week or two helping out in various ways. I know he'll be saying a couple of masses here and just getting acclimated in what essentially they give you 2 weeks of your vacation right away, so you can't take any more till next year. Just saying, that's how it works. But please pray for him, and then in about 2 weeks he'll move in to St. Catherine's in Reading and begin his ministry. So keep him in your prayers.
Yeah, we have one more announcement. By far, this is one of the best priests that ever been here in this cathedral. I have known him for a couple years. I'm very sad that he's leaving us, but I want you to know that this man is very humble. And many of you don't know, but this man speaks many languages, from Latin to Portuguese, Spanish. He doesn't speak that well English, but it's okay. But I learned how to preach thanks to him. I think he's one of the greatest preachers in the world. So I'm going to ask all of you to give him a big applause.
I just went on the record that I did not pay him to do that. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace. The Mass has ended. Hallelujah.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.